Hi there, this is Paula from Replicon. Replicon makes it easy for schedule managers to create and publish schedules that employees can then view via our web or mobile apps. In this video, I'm going to show you how scheduling works in Replicon, from when the administrator sets up shifts to when the end user views their schedule. I'll cover the difference between shift schedules and office schedules, creating shifts, a tour of the shift scheduling interface, assigning shifts to employees, editing, copying, and moving shifts, publishing shift schedules, and viewing shift schedules. This video will focus mainly on shift schedules, but before I start talking about those, I want to make sure all viewers understand the difference between the two types of schedules Replicon offers. You can assign users either office schedules or shift schedules. What's the difference? Office schedules are the simpler type of schedule. Office schedules always follow a recurring pattern. They are not variable. So for example, an office schedule could be for 8 hours per day from Monday to Friday, or it could be a recurring 8-day schedule of 4 12-hour days followed by 4 days off. But the bottom line is an office schedule always repeats a pattern. In contrast, shift schedules are variable. For example, a shift worker may work one shift 1 week, then switch to another the next week. Before your schedule manager can assemble shift schedules, they need administrators to create the building blocks of those schedules, the shifts. Administrators create all shifts that are used in schedules. To create a shift, the administrator clicks the shifts item, located under schedules on the administration page, then clicks Add Shift. After entering a name for the shift and ensuring its status is set to enabled, you can choose a color for the shift to display as. The color is important since schedule managers often rely on color coding to distinguish between shifts when laying out their schedules. Then add a default start and end time, and add any breaks that are required by selecting their start time, duration, and type. Note that when assembling a schedule, the schedule manager will be able to override the default shift times if necessary, but they won't be able to override break times. Once you click Save, this shift is available for use in schedules. The work of assembling shift schedules is carried out by a schedule manager. This is a specific role in Replicon that deals exclusively with schedules. But before we look at how to create schedules, let's take a quick tour of the scheduling page. First, open the scheduling page by clicking the schedule entry in the top menu. Note that you can change the date range in view, though the full date range you select may only be visible by scrolling, using the scroll bar at the base of the schedule. You can also change how much of the schedule is visible at a time by changing the zoom level using these buttons. All employees who've been assigned the Shift Schedule option in their user profiles will display in the left column of the scheduling grid. You can filter this list of employees using this filter field to make it easier to work with particular employees. You can filter by the username, shifts already assigned, skills users have been assigned in the project management section, and a couple of other options. Finally, notice the No User row at the top of the grid. You can use this row to hold shifts you need to add, but haven't yet decided where. Schedule managers create schedules by assigning the shifts that administrators created. You can assign one shift at a time, or assign the same shift multiple times at once. To assign a single shift to a single user, click the plus icon in the cell for that day and user. So in this case, I'm assigning a shift to Scott Coleman on February 22nd. You'll need to select the shift name. Note here that the default shift time the administrator set displays. You can update this time if needed. The edited time will display under the shift name in the schedule. Be aware that you cannot edit the break times included in the shift, so be wary of changing shift times too much. You can also add a note for the employee, such as what task they should focus on. These two fields, location and job, are custom fields. You can set up similar fields to help shift workers understand critical details about their shifts. Click Save, and the shift will be saved to the grid, in an unpublished state. I'll go over your publishing options in a few moments. You can also assign a shift to multiple days and to multiple users all at once. To do this, click the More button and select Add Assignments. From the dialog that displays, select all the users you want to assign the shift to. Then choose the date range you want the assignments to span, say March and April. Then select the days of the week the shift should appear on. I'll choose Monday, Wednesday, and Friday as an example. And finally, choose the shift, day 2, for example, and edit the time if necessary. The shift will appear on the selected dates. Once you have some shifts on your schedule, there's a good chance you'll want to move them around and alter them. To make changes to existing shifts, click Update Assignments. You'll need to select the user's shift or date range you want to update. Then you can select the new shift or enter a new work time or note here. Then click Apply. If I want to change all of Christina Jacobs' day 1 shifts in March to day 2 shifts, for example, I can do that. Note that if I update assignments for all users, changes will be applied even to users who don't appear in the scheduling grid due to filtering. If I want to move a localized group of shifts, that is, move shifts to new days without retaining them on the original dates, I can do that by selecting the shifts in question and dragging them to the new dates. Shifts can be moved anywhere, and you can move different types of shifts all at once. Or, there may be times when you want to copy existing shifts and paste them to new days, while retaining the shifts on the original days. In this case, select Copy and Paste Assignments. With this option, you can select users, shift, and a date range, and copy to a new date range. But note, with this option, you can only move a shift to a new date range that begins with the same day of the week. So this option is somewhat limited, but it does ensure weekly days off that have already been accounted for are respected when you copy shifts. Finally, if a shift needs to be assigned to consecutive days or to adjacent users on the same day, you can extend the shift across days by selecting the cell and hovering over the lower right-hand corner. Then click the orange square that displays and drag the cell across the rows or down the column to copy shifts. Note that these shifts that have been assigned and saved have stripes running across them. These stripes indicate that the shift has not yet been published, so it's not yet visible to the employee it's assigned to. To make shifts visible, you need to publish them. There are a couple of ways to do this. One, you can open a single shift and change the status setting to Published and click Save. Or, if you want to publish many shifts at once, select the Update Assignments option that we previously used to edit shifts. You'll need to select the date range and users whose shifts you want to publish. There is an All Users option if that helps you. Then you can choose a particular type of shift to publish, or leave this set to Any Shift if you want to publish all shifts in that range. Then, select Published from the status field and click Apply. This will also publish shifts hidden due to filtering. Finally, you can click the Publish button. This will publish all unpublished shifts visible in the date range you've selected. Shifts that have been filtered out will not be published. Once shifts are published, users can view them on their Schedules tab, located under My Replicon, in the Replicon web app. The color code associated with the shift type will display on the left edge of the shift box. But note that the employee will have to click on the shift to view any scheduled breaks. Or you can add a schedule component to their timesheet tab, so they can view their schedule there. If employees want to view their schedule while on the go, they can tap the Schedule menu item in the Replicon mobile app, then tap the week they want to view. That's about all there is to know about shift scheduling in Replicon. If you need more help, feel free to visit our Help Center at www.replicon.com/help. Visit our community or contact our support team. That's all from me for now. Thanks for your time.